According to the Education Sector Progress Report for the financial year 2021-2022, presented by the District Education Officer for Yumbe District during an education conference at Aringa Secondary School, only 6,634 learners out of the 28,302 who enrolled in Primary 1 7 years ago were able to reach Primary 7 and sit for this year's primary leaving examinations, of which 2,593 were girls and 4,041 were boys, including refugees.
Out of this, we had 13,836 girls and we had 14,466 boys. This year, those who managed to go through the circle and reach P7, we had a total of 6,634 learners or candidates whom we successfully registered to sit QLE.
Rosalind Ajiko, a lecturer at Somali International University, challenged parents to prioritize parenthood over work.
They were born to be a blessing. They were not born to be discarded. They are born to be prosperous, such that their mind is focused to achieve that greatness for which God has created them. Because all of us were created for a purpose.
Stella Knight Chandiru, an education specialist with UNICEF, and other district leaders appealed to stakeholders to find a solution to the increasing number of school dropouts.
For our community, disaster for the Aringa people and disaster for Yumbe district as a fraternity. And this is something that should really, really concern us.
With such kind of education, who is going to man the big picture of AIDA? Whose children are you going to employ in all these schools, in these agricultural institutions, in these universities?
Michael Tebere, a technical advisor on local economic development promoting rural development programs in northern Uganda, appealed to parents to support establishment of a modern school in the district.
And we now used to pack our children on buses to go and take the money back out of Yumbe to schools in Kampala. Let us keep that money in Yumbe here by investing in a model school.
Report compiled by Adam Gule for the news.